A long time ago, in a galaxy far, far away, there was an excellent series of movies made called Star Wars. And one of the most important vehicles in Star Wars was the Imperial TIE Fighter. Everyone remembers this. Even people who aren't fans of Star Wars would recognize the TIE Fighter design. It is so cool. We're going to say iconic. Everybody knows the design, and now I get to build one up on the show. AMT via Round 2 Models is reissuing the authentic Imperial TIE Fighter. They have the Disney license. They are retooling kits. They are improving them. This one's got improved wing tooling to improve the accuracy on the kit. So let's start taking a look at the parts that will be in the box. First, though, we will look at the box. It's got the sweet retro box art with the Stormtrooper. We got some X-Wings. We got TIE Fighters. We got the front one on here, which can be used as a color guide on the front. It is using the original Star Wars logo, the Luke over Leia there with his lightsaber. On the side gives you some more painting ideas in full color. And then the back of the box is your paint guide in color for the model. It gives you the exact names of Tamiya colors to use, and you can find conversion charts, or you can just do it by eye, which is what most of the model builders at ILM did. They just mixed up paints and sprayed them, and a lot of the ones aren't the same color. Listening to Adam Savage talk about it is pretty awesome because it drives the know-it-alls nuts, and that's what I like about his show. So you can see the cockpit in there, fully detailed. The front end, the side, the back end, and then all the reference colors to get it close to what they used on the movies. We've got a clear parts tree here for the upper hatch, which looks like it will be able to open, and the front glass. Got that cool diamond shape to it, which replicates that right on the front there. Now, the filming models, if you wanted to say this was closer to a filming model, you wouldn't put any glass in it at all, because this would have reflected poorly on camera. So the X-Wings, the TIE Fighters, the ones they used for filming, didn't have any glass in them at all. Very, very simple instruction sheet, so we'll show you on this one. The pilot is made up of four pieces. Then we've got his chair. The pilots were so cool looking, with those dual hoses to breathe and stuff like that. They were like little beginner Darth Vaders. Then we have the full interior, which goes into the fuselage or the chassis. Then we attach our side wings, our nose, and everything. So the build process should be quite easy. On the show so far, you've seen me build the X-Wing, Darth's TIE Fighter, and Boba Fett's Starfighter, Slave 1. So those are all on the back there. We've seen all those on the show. And cool, I don't have a lot of model news, but supposedly they are building or designing a 1/32nd scale TIE Fighter. That thing's going to be massive, like massive. The turret is going to be like this big. So they're going to be developing one of those and coming out. I can't wait to get that on the bench. But for now, we'll be happy with this model, which has plenty of great details. Molded in a nice gray, you can paint it. You could build it as it is. That gray, that blue-gray looks a lot like the screen. Superb details for inside the cockpit, just mirror images. Check out all the little greeblies from the movie molds. Got our back, got our top hatch, got our front grid for the cockpit, got the control area, got the back of the cockpit. All nicely looking, well detailed. Backsides don't need anything on them. Then we've got our pilot, which does look better than a lot of the old MPC pilots from the day. The ones in the Snowspeeder are quite poor, but these ones you can actually see the hoses and stuff. So we'll see if we can detail that with a little dry brushing. We've got sides of the rear of the craft, some thrusters. We've got the pilot's seat and the control area, like the dashboard for him. On this part here, we've got the floor of the cockpit. Imperial people are always obsessed with that little grid. Got parts of our hatches, looks like some blaster parts, and then the each halves of the pod, or the fuselage, or the chassis, whatever you want to call it. I think the detail on these is very nice. I know some people saying these are older kits, so the detail's a little soft, but I like them. And finally, the newly tooled side wings with their solar panels. Beautiful, crisp detail on there. Be very careful when you're cutting these mold grids off. You don't want to ruin that edge. Very, very sharp, especially when molded in that gray, like it's like a gray primer. You can really tell a color on there. And then it's exact twin on the other side. All the little greebly details in the center. They spend some time accurizing those, making them more to scale, even though these don't really exist. They put a lot of time in them. So we thank round two for that. I'm gonna start gluing mine together and we'll be back in a second. Thank you. a relaxing, quick, easy, super easy build session. I can tell you from the start that this kit could be built by anyone with little to no model experience at all. So if you've been looking at building a TIE Fighter and don't want to spend too much money, you can get one of these AMT kits. It's going to go together quite easily. I like to cut parts free and get them ready for paint. I'll leave some parts on the trees. Anything that I cut off on the sides, if this is your first model build kit, you can just quickly touch up with some of the final coat by using a paintbrush and a little spritz and a cup of the main color. So we've got our upper hatch. We've got the outside of the solar panels that will mount right here when we're all done. We've got our rear thruster. That's our engine port. That goes on the back of the fuselage when we're all done. As you saw, these two parts go together easily. They are a little warped. You can see they go together. They're a little warped. Doesn't matter with the TIE Fighter kit. Once they're pressed together, they look great. The seams line up. You can't even tell they're there, really. They're on a natural seam, on a natural angle. And the reason they don't really matter is that these ends will interlock into the solar panels, and then we'll attach those large pieces on the outside. So we're not going to have to worry about any warpage. If we weren't doing that, it'd be a bummer, but it doesn't matter with this shape here. Got our laser blasters glued in because they are going to be body color, except for the very tips, which I will paint the color of the lasers. So those are all set. Those little teeny tiny pieces, don't forget them on the part sheet. You want to make sure you glue those in. We got our little thrusters on the side. I just cut them mostly free from the parts trees so I can get some paint on them and then glue them. The reason I couldn't attach them in advance is because when the fuselage parts come together, and they do come together with these large pegs, which do fit in nicely, you can see that where those horizontal holes are on the front and the back, that's where those will attach. So those can be put on once we get the cockpit inside and everything else working on the kit. I need this cockpit glass support, this window. I need that to be a darker color than the rest of the vehicle, so that is cut separately. I also want to do the interior up. Even though we won't be able to see much of it, we'll be able to see enough. And I like the Star Wars kit, so I like to detail them a little bit. I want to paint the side panels once we're all together. So we got the cockpit floor and the main body. I will spray that together. I left off the fourth side, which is right here, so I can detail it. Then I can also reach in with my paint pens and markers and brushes and detail the control panel and all of that, and the panel up front here. And then I can put the seat in, the pilot, and then attach the side panel with just a little bit of super glue. It actually fits on nicely. And this way, doing only three of the four sides, we get it to square up. We know it's going to fit inside the fuselage. We've got the pilot himself all glued together, and he fits together nicely. I clamp the body together. Once that's painted black and gloss coated and done a little detail, that's going to look lovely. And then we have the pilot's chair, which we can separately detail, then attach the pilot, get him in there, and then place all of that with those large marks into the floor of the cockpit. The location is, whoa, this plastic is so slippery, super smooth, right in those large marks at the bottom, so there's no mistake about where you can put that seat. The solar panels, I just clipped off some of the molding lugs and the side lugs. A great set of Xerons, sharp side cutters, will carefully cut those off, and then we can just sand any roughness down. This part I'll hang on to and then cut it off, and if I need to, I can just quickly touch up the paint on the bottom side. So the solar panels are all set. What I will do is get all this primed in a black tone, then spray the lighter tones over it, and then we will mask off each individual panel and spray all this stuff. So we're going to go through a good amount of masking tape on that. I will be right back with the paint booth. Before I wrap up my lovely little build of AMT's TIE Fighter from Star Wars, thought I'd stop, show you some of the stuff I've been using and what we were going through. Now, you saw me paint all the parts, and then I gave them that gray Tamiya paint, and then I misted a little bit of blue over it. That's the tint, the color tone that I like. I like that gray-blue look, but not all in one. I like it a little mottled. So that's how I build my models. Then we give them that black wash. I did not black wash the wing panels with the solar panel. I was able to achieve enough of a shadow with the spray painting that I didn't feel that I needed more. The fuselage, the end caps of the solar panel and stuff, I thought could use a little more. So that's what I did with it. We've got the glue drying. I used super glue to hold the pod together. I did not use any glue to hold the cockpit in. I used an extremely, like a pinhead amount of super glue in 3 points to hold the glass on. The glass on the inside, of course, you saw was held on with Mod Podge because that will not fog glass. Super glue can fog glass, so if you were worried about it at first, you could always brush on or dip the clear glass parts in future floor polish or quick shine. Any type of acrylic clear should help keep that from fogging, but I was just extremely careful. I also left the top off while it dries. Then I added some super glue to those pins, as you saw, and pressed the sides together. And now we're clamping those together because they had a little bit of a warp, which will be cured by the solar end panels. But I wanted to make it a more secure connection, so I ran a little bit of super glue inside the tubes and then clamped them together with my little clamps. You can pick these up like a 6 or a 10 pack at the dollar store now. I got a lot of these red ones long before they were that in the stores like that. So we're all set. You can see inside that cockpit. It looks pretty cool. Let's get some light in there. You can see down in there. You can see the pilot, the background. You can see it through the glass. So it looks definitely passable in a vehicle where it's closed off like that. We've got the engines on. So when you're attaching these four little pieces on the pod, make sure that the pieces with thrusters are out the back. Then we've got our engines here. And then the more smooth ones, the directions show as being in the front because we have our laser blasters right there. So that's how that will look when it's together. And we'll let that dry with the lid off so that any fumes from the super glue that happen to be in these arms and on the winch can get out the top and won't sit inside and ferment and fog that glass. Now, the top does normally have a hinge where you can open it up. Well, I'd have to find a way to pry that up to take pictures at the end. So I just cut the hinges off. That's still going to drop in and fit just fine. So that will sit like so on the top of the ball of the fuselage and be nice. Then all we have to do is press our wing panels on, which I think with all that masking turned out super nice. Better than when I hand painted Darth Vader. They're a lot more crisp on this one. These panels here at the very end are keyed. You can see the key mark up here. You can see on the panel, it's in black, but you see where that little lip is right there. That will press in, and that's a friction fit. So that shouldn't need any glue at all. And that will be the end panels for the wings. And then that will be it. We'll be have a final. We don't have a stand. It does have this removable piece here that I've got in there. If they ever come out with a stand for it, we can install it on a stand as if it's in flight. And that is all. That's all we're going to have. So when I come back, we'll have those pieces on and our final. Now, to go over some stuff in the video you're always wondering about, the tape that I use to mask off a lot of stuff is called washi tape. It's a craft tape. Easy to find at any craft store, Hobby Lobby, Michaels, Joann Fabrics. They usually come in a tube of like 10 rolls, lasts forever. And the big yellow tape is frog tape for delicate surface. Comes in a plastic container. It's available at places like Menards or whatnot. I use it. I've had this roll for a couple years now, and I build way more cars and vehicles than most people build. Works very well and never peels anything off. In the pipette, you will wonder what I'm using when I squirt it on the super glue. That is super glue activator. Now, I use this little tester's container just to hold it, but I buy it by a big bottle, and I think it was an 8-ounce bottle, is around 15 years old. You just need a little tiny half of a drop of the pipette super glue activator to activate it. Currently, I'm using crazy glue from the dollar store. I also use those little red containers. It's super glue. It works fine. Just depends on what they have in stock. And gel super glue for parts that you don't want the glue to run anywhere and you want to have some more time to move it. This takes like about a minute to dry. This takes a few seconds, 10 to 20 seconds. Activator on either will set them instantly. And limited edition weathering socks will be available from HPI Guys Workshop for only $400 a piece. The inflation has hit us. They used to be $100, now they're $400. That's what you see me using to dab off my homemade weathering mix. And that homemade weathering mix, as you saw, was Windex mixed with craft paint in whatever solution, whatever amount you need to make it as thin as you need to run. I start out at 50-50 mix. And then I go from there. So that's all the stuff I've been using. When I come back, we'll have the final on the awesome TIE Fighter. AMT's Star Wars Imperial TIE Fighter is done. A very easy 2-day build. Even if you include the masking time, you can use standard masking tape to mask off those solar panels. You could build it out of the box. You could get two of them, let the kids build one as it is with the all gray panels. The blue gray that it's molded in does look pretty darn close to what I saw in the movies and would be easily passable any way you wanted to build it. Then really the only thing would be using some black paint to paint the figure inside and the solar panels. It can be done freehand. I've done it in the Darth Vader video, or just use a couple feet of masking tape and do it yourself. I really enjoy these builds. I'm not gonna stop building the Star Wars stuff. Did you hear that they are reissuing Anakin's pod racer? Oh, I never had a chance to build or own that kit in the 90s when it was released. Big time going to be doing that on the show. But this one is the Imperial TIE Fighter. Round 2's got the United States Star Wars license, and they are pushing out these kits. They've got the improved solar panels. Or they call them wings. You can call them whatever you want. They're supposed to be solar panels, I think, according to the movies. And they did a beautiful job. The detail on them is phenomenal. All the little greeblies. The fit and finish is very nice. As you see, I didn't use a drop of filler on anything. I rarely do unless it's glaring. And the seam of the fuselage right down the sides is perfect. There's no gaps, there's no issues. The engines fit on the back. The little pod pieces that glue the pod together, they all fit in. The hatch fits in, the windshield fits in, the figure fits in, and the figure doesn't look half bad. I mean, for some of those in the old days, they were pretty poor figures, but the one in here is very nice. And you can hinge that upper cockpit access hatch, the one right here coming around, and you can display it open or closed. I cut the hinges off mine so we can look at it in the pictures. I just really enjoy these Star Wars kits. They get me excited. I have so much fun with them. And when they're simple to build yet look as cool as this thing does, makes it all the better. As always, thanks for watching the workshop. Build your models for you. Show me all the different stuff you make on the Facebook page, whether it's Star Wars, whether it's cars, trucks, airplanes, tanks. I like all models. You know that. I practice zero model snobbery, and I want to see it. Show me some of the different color variations you could do with your TIE Fighter. I thought about doing that with this one, but then I decided I haven't had a chance to build one of these really ever, and I did want to build it up and just like it would look to me in the movie when I was a kid. Thanks for watching the workshop. We'll see all of you at the next review.